Hi students, let's continue with the PDA concept. So the PDA, before going to see the examples, you have to know some terminologies that are related to the pushdown automata. So if you know these terminologies, then you can understand the problems. So the first terminology that is related to the pushdown automata is the instantaneous description. So that you call it as simply ID. So the ID, what is this ID that you have to know that? Because we use this ID in the pushdown automata. Well, that is one of the terminology. The instantaneous description, that is the ID of a PDA, is represented by a triple. So means the ID is represented a triple. Means three terms will be there. QWS. QWS. So Q is nothing but the state. So at present you are in which state? You are starting with the initial state, means write it as a Q naught. If you are start next state, if the state is changed, means you have to write it as a Q1, like that. Okay, the start, this is the, it represents the state. Now coming to W in the left hand side. So left hand side and the right hand side will be there, but the left hand side you represent it as an ID. Okay, so this W is nothing but unconsumed input. Unconsumed input means still you are not we didn't read that complete data. That the finite state machine is not read data. That is whatever the data that is present in the input stack. So in this, you have seen in the diagram. Okay, in the previous diagram, the pushdown automata is consisting of divided into three parts. Okay, one is the finite state, finite control unit, and this stack, and the input tape. Okay, input tape will be there. So that input consisting, the tape consisting of the unconsumed input first, that is the W, and S is the stack content. So what is there in the stack? Starting whatever it may. Next, what is the top of the stack? Next, what element is there in the stack? So the elements that are present in the stack, that you have to write here. This is a representation of ID. The instantaneous description of a pushdown automata is represented by a triple. So remember this triple, that is, this is, the format is like this only. First, the Q has to be right, that is a state. And W, that is an unconsumed input. And S is a stack content. Suppose whenever if I write in the problems, if it is represented in the three state, means that is nothing but it is an instantaneous description you are writing for that given grammar. For the given grammar, you have to write, represent that that grammar in this three triples. Okay, in triples. Remember this QWS. Q is a state, W is the unconsumed input, and S is a stack contents. So here ID is informal notation of how a PDA computes an input string and make a decision that string is accepted or rejected. Actually, this QWS is informal notation, not as a formal notation. Just for the sake of solving the problem, whether the string is accepted or rejected, the PDA has to compute the input string, whatever the input string, suppose A, B, B, A. This is the input string we are given. So this input string is accepted by PDA or not, that decision has to be taken, that by using this informal notation ID. With the help of this informal notation ID, the PDA is going to compute this input string and makes a decision that string is accepted or rejected. So that is one terminology. And next, coming to the another terminology, that is a turnstile notation. So this is the representation of turnstile notation. Just like the T has to be in like this, it should be converted. Okay, it is fallen T. You call it as a fallen T. Let's take. It is used for connecting pairs of IDs that represent one or many moves of a PDA. So the turnstile notation is used for connecting pair of IDs. The pair of IDs will be there. Suppose two IDs will be there. So the pair of IDs has to be connected by using this turnstile notation. So here turnstile notation is used for connecting pair of IDs that represent one or many moves of PDA. So the process of transition is denoted by the turnstile symbol. So this is a symbol. So this is represents one move. Suppose if only one is there, only one move has to be taken. Means from one state to another state, whenever a state is changing, that means the input symbol is changing. From A to B, suppose you are reading, starting your in A, you read A, and now you want to read B, means the state, the input symbol is changing. Whenever the input symbol is changing, automatically the state has to be changed. Okay, the state has to be changed. That means one move has to be done. So that will be, that move represents the turnstile notation. So here the sign describes a sequence of the moves. Suppose if it is the turnstile symbol, here the star is there. This star, this sign describes the sequence of moves. Means there are many moves. See here in the example, then you understand what is this turnstile notation. PBT, it's a triple ID. This is one ID and this is another ID. These two IDs are connecting. The connecting the pair of IDs, which is represented one or many moves of a PDA. So here while taking a transition from P to Q, okay, this is one state. Starting is an ID, this is a state, there is unconsumed input, and this is a stack content, whatever the stack content consisting of. So first here in the left hand side, while taking a transition from P to Q, here the one move is there. We are changing the state. Means the input symbol B, the input symbol B is consumed. Okay, that is consuming. And top of the stack T is represented with a new string A. So now the top of the stack consisting of, top of the stack consisting of A. Okay. So in the unconsumed, B is consumed and the top of the stack is A. So this is the way you have to represent the turnstile notation. So remember these two notation, the ID, instantaneous description, and the turnstile notation. If you understand these two terms, then only you can understand how you are going to convert the given context-free grammar into the pushdown automata. So first of all, how we are going to design the pushdown automata for the given grammar. Okay, thank you.